Alright guys, the time has come, Nautis Home Early Access is out, you can get it, and you can start sailing. Well, to be honest, this is the first time I am running Nautis Home, so I didn't test anything before. This is literally the first view I will get, and I would like to notice two things. First of all, I'm not getting paid by VSTEP to do this video. I'm doing this because I want to show you guys Nautis Home and maybe help you with a decision if it's worth it for you or not. And second of all, this is an early access version, which means the software is not completely finished. It is usable, but there might be bugs. There might be like not too much stuff going on in the software because development is still going on. But we are able to have a look at it already. So, first of all, what do you get with Nautis Home? Well, you will get the simulation and you will get courses, as you can see here. So basically, those are like tutorials. They will explain you how does a ship work. For the most people who are using a simulation, this is like not very interesting because, well, you know what starboard and port is and you know how a ship, like in the basics, work. But for someone who never used a simulation or never had any contact to a ship, it might be very interesting. Then there's also an introduction to the software itself. You can learn how to maneuver a ship, and there are some like technical stuff about the ships in Nautis Home, but we're not gonna do this. We wanna see the real deal. So we got a software here. This is the launcher for Nautis Home, and in this launcher we can start Nautis Home. Can also check the application, we can go to the community and to the learning platform, which I have opened here. So, well, let's go, let's start Nautis Home. All right. Yep. Let's see how this is going. I hope the loading time isn't too long, because we could have awkward silence then. Oh, all right, we're already in. So as we can see, we have two options, an introduction and a maneuvering training, and we have the free roam option. So let's just do the introduction. All right, using the controls, reading the instruments, using the chart, using the radar. All right, so let's get into the controls, I guess. Alright, so we get a quick briefing. Using the controls, move the controls and watch how the ship reacts. Remember that ships are heavy, so it takes a while before you notice any effect. This is the Sonidel, an inland oil tanker, and it weighs 3,680 tons. Alright, good. Alright, well, this looks very interesting. Okay, so we can look around. All right. Like, the first impression is, honestly, I like the look. It already looks very, very professional to me. It doesn't look like a game or something like that, but more really like an educational software. So the graphics now with those settings are totally fine for me. I don't think that graphics are, when it comes to like simulations, are the most important factor, but it actually is like the whole dynamics of the ship and stuff. So, all right, let's try this out. We're gonna give it some power. Oh, we can see the RPM going up, and we can also see that we're going 0.8 knots. Now we've reached 1 knot. All right, let's go full ahead. Let's see what this bad boy can do. Right. So, we got a chart. I think when you click here, you can move it. If you have two windows, you can move it to another window, and I think you can make it bigger. Should be. Alright. Yeah, like this. So this is, of course, not like Actis type quality. Let's test the rudder. Alright, lovely. This works pretty well. Okay. Like, I got no sound right now. Is there sound? I don't know. Oh, we can switch between light and dark. This is pretty cool. Right, it should behave pretty solidly, I would say. Right. That river pilot, whatever that is. Let's see. Okay, so this enables full mouse control, as we can see. Like, you don't even need like arrow keys or stuff. You can do everything just with the mouse, which is, I guess, a good thing. Alright, radar, filter rain, filter C, EBL. How is this usable? Alright, yeah. Well, it's drag and drop, which is cool. VRHM. Also works. Mode, let's make it head up. Can change the range. Yeah, well, this is pretty solid, I think. This is pretty solid. Alright. We got an echo sounder. We can see our roll. We can see the speed of wind. This is actually sweet. So, but what is our mission right now? Briefing. Move to controls and watch how the ship reacts. Remember, the ships are heavy, so it takes a while before you notice any effect. Right. So they want us to play around with this a little. So we will do this. Yeah, alright. Like, I'm not a professional, so I really can't, like, judge the physics in this, but I need to admit that they feel really, really good, in my opinion. Oh, we can change the view. Oh, we can give it a binocular view. This is pretty cool. Alright, we can look starboard and port. Can look at the stern. We can also look at the bow. So we can also look from the outside, as you can see, and we can also zoom in and zoom out, which is working quite well. Yep. All right. We had this already. So, is this our bow thruster? Yeah, I would say it seems like it. Alright, yeah, well, okay, if you double click on it, it will reset to the zero position, which is nice. I like stuff like that. Alright, perfect. Let's get out of here and let's have a look at the ships we can get and the environments. So we have English Channel, the training area, Gulf of Mexico, Rio de Janeiro, New York, Sydney, and Hong Kong. I want to have Hong Kong for sure. The vessels. Well, we've got the Leocadia, the MV Gorfit, the Vigo, Olina, etc. pp. So there's a tugboat. I really want to try this out, to be honest. We're gonna give it the calm weather, so we have a lot of options to change here, but we will leave it like that. Now we can place where we want to start. So this is very similar to the old ship simulator, actually. And we want to start right here, I would say. And let's see. Right, loading times are okay. I'm using an SSD, so might be slower if you're using it on an HDD. And I can't also talk about the whole performance. For me, the performance is good. I think I have a 3060 as a graphics card in my PC and an AMD Ryzen whatever and 16 gigs of RAM. So it works good. This is like not fluid 60 FPS kind of AAA gameplay, but I don't think it's needed anyways because you're gonna have like a fixed camera angle. So even if you run this on like 20, 25, 30 FPS, it shouldn't be too much of a problem. All right, got some lovely tugboat here. Let's have a look from the outside. Yeah, well, this looks actually quite nice, I need to admit. Like the. No, we've got some issues here. All right. Yeah, the quality is totally all right. I don't really mind it, but this is like a personal thing, actually. Let's go in here again. All right. Let's see how this bad boy behaves. But there's no sound, as it seems. This is kind of odd, actually. Wait, let me check if there is sound. Stop. There's like no options, as we can see right here. Wait, let me see. Oh, there is no sound. So, well, this is like a very odd thing that there is no sound, but I guess it will be coming. Come on, let's take the big container vessel. Let's look how this looks. All right. But it's really odd that you don't have sound, honestly. I think this is really odd. I mean, I don't mind too much, to be honest, but some sort of motor sound or ambient sound wouldn't be too bad. If you want to compensate for it, just like you could look up on YouTube some bridge noise video and might be kind of okay-ish, but yeah, this is something which should be fixed. I'm pretty certain that it will come. All right, we got the MV shipping one right here, which looks huge. It's actually all pretty nice models in my opinion. I mean, they're not real ships, of course, but they are looking quite good, actually. All right, let's go to the helm again, and let's see. Just gonna give it full ahead. So, gonna our gyroscope right here. See, let's give it like a really, really sharp turn to port, so we can have a look at the section right here. All right, so we can see the degree of the rudder. No, it's 35, and we can see the ship turning. So this takes a lot of time to get this thing to speed, which is, of course, realistic. The echo sounder is showing us the depth under our lovely ship. Got the wind right here, which angle it's coming at, which speed. Radar going, which seems to be pretty precise actually. We can filter the sea. All right, okay, I see. Yeah, well, interesting, very, very interesting. I will play around a lot with this, I can tell you for sure, because this is like really exciting. The chart is like not type of actus quality, of course, but I think it's totally fine to know where you are going. Can turn those off if you want. Okay. Can change conditions. Has it seen? Oh, alright. It's pretty cool. Let's give it like the really, really bad weather. So there should be like thunders and stuff. Oh. Oh yeah, okay, you can see the radar is going completely nuts over the rain. And we can filter it. Can also filter the sea and then it should return to normal. Oh, wait. Alright, so it seems you have like some sort of noise going on the radar even if you enable the filtering, which is cool, I guess. Alright, this is pretty solid, I think. Can turn off the rain, it works directly. Very cloudy. Oh, we can change the current direction. Oh, we can also change the current speed. Okay. Interesting. Very interesting. Strong winds. Let's see. Let's give it really strong wind. What does it look by night? Holy shit. You're not seeing anything. Damn, well, I guess that's realistic. Wow, alright. Oh. I don't think it looks too bad. I think it looks really cool, actually. Like, it's not the type of AAA graphics, but it looks really, really good for a simulation, in my opinion. Yeah, alright. Away. Alright. Oh, we can also change the visibility, of course. Oh. Oh, wow. Alright. Well. This seems like hell on earth. Yeah, well, oh, holy shit. I can see anything. Sorry for swearing. Damn, this is interesting. Very, very interesting. And, well, to get a little conclusion here. It is early access, so there is not too much stuff to do. I don't know about the missions. Let's see. So the training is using the controls, reading the instruments, using the chart, using the radar. Then there is the maneuvering course. So this is everything you get right now. And of course the free roam. No multiplayer right now too. This will come in the future, I got told. But yeah, if you want to learn some stuff about ships and how to steer a ship, how to take control, this might be very, very interesting to you. There's of course some stuff to do. You can try out all kinds of vessels, as you can see here. And there are courses on the website of Nautis. So if you want to try it, I would say give it a go for like €6 a month. You can just cancel the subscription and you pay it six times only for basically trying out. It's okay in my opinion. It is a hard topic with like software subscription models, of course, but yeah, for me it's fine. I've got 1 month and I will try this out. I guess I will make an update video once I know more, but this is like the first view of my first impression of Nautis Home, and I hope you enjoyed the video.